you. He has not heard about you, but he is giving you a chance to live and not to die. He's giving you a chance to be called a son and not an enemy. He's giving you a chance to spend your eternity in heaven and not in hell. What a good God. Now the whole nation will come together. We want to give praises and thanks. We bow down to ancestors. We bow down to graven images. God said he's jealous and will pour his anger upon a nation that has forsaken him. Brethren, when you have the mercies of God, let's look at the book of Luke chapter 7. Read verses 11 to 15 and see how merciful our God is. Luke 7, 11 to 15.
Gospel according to St. Luke chapter 7, verse 11 to 15. Now it happened the day after that he went into a city called Nain, and many of his disciples went with him, and a large crowd. And when he came near the gate of the city, behold, a dead man was being carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow, and a large crowd from the city was with her. Verse 13. When the Lord saw her, he had compassion on her, and said to her, "Do not weep." Then he came and touched the open coffin, and those who carried him stood still. And he said, "Young man, I say to you, arise." So he who was dead sat up and began to speak, and he presented him to his mother.
Brethren, we need the mercy of God. Here is an example. A woman, a widow, with only one son, who probably would have been a helper. But one day, the only son died, and she's a widow. And people gathered to help her to cry. Professional weepers, people who know how to do burial. Benin City is the headquarters. There is no Friday, people are not going to join other people for burial except we of this church. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Once a leader is not interested in a thing, that thing can never be done. Am I correct? I'm not interested in burial. So you are not allowed to die.
Amen.
Is that clear? Yes. If your parents die, tell them to keep them until the day of resurrection. Because nobody has money for burial. We are looking for money for the gospel now. But that woman, people join her for burial. Nobody told us the background of this woman. Whether she was a deaconess or just an ordinary woman, it's not the case. There is no record to show that this woman fasted and prayed, but she was in a sad condition. She was crying. She was sad and sorrowful. A man that is anointed by God, who knows all things at the same time. Listen to this. Jesus Christ. He knows the names of everybody throughout the whole world. But he can consign Jesus Christ with Edo name, with Yoruba names, with Igbo names, with Hausa names, with Ijaw names. He knows all. Listen to this carefully. This Jesus I'm talking about, he understands all these languages throughout the whole world if they are spoken at the same time. Let's assume that we are calling on me here right now. Is he hearing us or not?
Yes,
that is how he's hearing them in Sapele. He is hearing them in Lagos. He is hearing them in Oyo. He is hearing them in Ibadan. He is hearing them in London. He is hearing them in Germany. He is hearing them in Luxembourg. He is hearing them in Holland. He is hearing them in the United States. He is hearing them in Japan, in China. He is hearing them all over the whole world at the same time, which is about 20 to 12 now. He is hearing all the people who are calling on him on various languages. Stand up if you believe and shout a big hallelujah to this God. It's a wonderful thing to be a Christian. Please be seated. Only the Christian believe in this. His omnipotence, omniscience, omnipresence. And he stood saying, my heart, somebody's cry. A merciful God. Only a wicked person takes delight in seeing people suffering. That is why our leaders shall be held accountable for as many Nigerians that are perishing in abroad, in Europe. I was so surprised because there is no job in Europe. Our guys that are having the residential permit are back again to the road for prostitution. I was not told. I saw them dressed in half naked dresses along the road waiting for any man who will take them for sex business. And I will tell you that 90% plus are from Edo State. And out of that 90, let's take it, maybe 83, 85 are Ishan and Benis. Ishans are really very well in prostitution, like the Benin people. Anyway, Ishans, Benin, are they not the same? Our people are trying again now. They took me to the train station in Italy, in Holland. What is their business there? Cocaine. Because there is no job to do, no salary, and you will pay for your rent. The normal rent in Italy for 3 bedrooms flat is up to 800 euros. Some are six, let me put it between 600 to 800. That is the normal houses where Nigerians are living. As a result, they took me because I want to know what to tell you. They took me to the train station where young Nigerians are sitting from morning to evening. There is no job. And any opportunity they have, cocaine. And the police have surrounded the train station now. Because the police there, they work to prevent. There, they plan to prevent. Before the cocaine spread, they have combed that area. Hallelujah. We need the mercy of God for the government of Nigeria to have the problem of the inhabitants in their heart. Look, my son showed me where a policeman died in Italy at the train station. Why? A man that carried cocaine, they now use bicycle. Bicycle is a luxury in Europe. Some bicycle cost more than 300,000 naira. Yes, bicycle. And the young man put cocaine and he rides a bicycle. And the policeman was around. Immediately accosted him because information is going on. The bicycle rider dumped down his bicycle, took to his heels, and crawl the right way. You know, we have some small trams No, they cross anywhere. He crossed it. And the policeman pursued him to cross it. They knock him down. He died on the spot. But the cocaine Nigeria pusher ran away. And so, today, the police in Italy are very angry with Nigerians. And any criminal, maybe Senegalese, maybe Ghanaian, when you hold it, they say, we are Nigerians. Well, they like that. The ambassador of Nigeria in Italy is need to be called to order to give account of the work that his people are doing there. They charge as much as 800. I'm saying it for the public to hear. Between 800 to 1,000 euro for a passport, for Nigerian passport. Here, it costs how much? Eh? Okay. Under 100 euro. In Europe, 800 to 1,000 euro. Is that the work we send ambassador to go and be doing to our children in Europe? The federal government did well. They said they should be paying online. How much? Whether 40 something or something. Not a few dollars. But before you know it, they kill it in the embassies. You must pay by cash. We need the mercies of God for our leaders and those who represent them to be doing the correct thing. Brethren, this woman was going with the corpse on the head to go and bury. And this man called Jesus, who understand your condition as he understood the condition of that widow woman. The widow woman did not pray, did not fast, did not call on Jesus. Jesus, hold on, see what is happening. No, she was busy mourning. And they were on the way to the cemetery. And Jesus came to her. She didn't go to Jesus. Merciful, very merciful God. He crossed over. And disciples said, where are you going? He said, wherever people are crying, I'm always interested. And he went to the woman and stopped the movement of those who were carrying the ambulances. You know, in Benin, we are used to raising up alarms. Babu, 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 only for burial. Over there in abroad, that word, babu for sarin in an ambulance, you can only find it in ambulance. And also, in this firefighting vehicles. And they have their good road. Oh, let me not go there today. Immediately we arrived. I spent 3 hours between the airport and to get my vehicle out of the parking place. And when we are back on the road, I have to buckle up and tighten my neck because bad roads as what? I started. And my sadness and sorrow again over the nation of Nigeria started. For some weeks, I have not anything called gallop. No. No gallop. No gallop. No pothole. No death trap. There is go slow. We need to know what to do. They have go slow. It is something we must pray for the mercy of God. About 3 lanes we were going. My horse said, watch, what is going to happen to the motorist? They drew the line. For one, they crossed the line to come and join one. They crossed this way to come and join one. 3 lanes are now going to become how many lanes? 1 lane. Our wish, all the governors and commissioner for transport and road and what, they should go and learn that one. They are going there every day. They travel more than me. The immediate one in the front, you just go in, it goes. This one, we want to come in only, you only show your trafficator. It is an offense for the one to refuse to give you chance. Oh my God. You don't want to tell about it? Eh? Here, you will back, trafficate, bring out your hand, beg and beg. That is the time we change the agenda and do what? And their eyes will change on their heads. Brethren, they were going. This one will come in, it will go, it will go. This one will not come in, it will go. They were taking their turn one by one. And the thousands of vehicles formed only one line. Why? The bridge that is as wide as this church hall was lifted up, just like the whole of this ground will be lifted up. We roll to the sky, to the height, and the sheep will pass the river under. How can I describe it to you? You have no river, no better river in Nigeria. Neither do you have better bridge. Neither do you have engineers. What will I tell you? And it told Debel, only those who get there can describe it. They just block the way. I say, I'm a road. Until the ship we pass, there is no more bridge, no more road. And when they will roll the bridge and bring it back, all the cement, everything, oh my God, oh Nigeria, oh God, we need your mercy. We who sell oil to the European countries are now borrowing us money. The best roads I've ever seen, not America. America have gigantic ones, but Holland, what we call road network connection, is in Holland. It's very beautiful. It's money. When the Minister of Roads and Transport, if you want him to do, to perform, Commissioner, don't blame anybody. Corruption is for everybody, including the church, including Christian. There is no department in Nigerian government, Nigerian system that is not what? Corrupt. Only we cry to the government that they would have been able to stop their colleagues from this league of corrupt practices. Brethren, we need the mercy of God that our minister will be able to be buying good aeroplanes to stop killing innocent, what do you call them, Nigerians. We need it. We need it. How many plane crash within these past few years? And how many people have died? Potentials have died. Meaningful men, reasonable men, highly educated, have passed away through the careless work and corruption of the Ministry of Aviation. Just as they do in the Ministry of the Motor Licensing Office. I'm saying that you are all watching me now. That is why they are arresting me and harassing me at the airport, because I speak the truth. How come that you are charging for roadworthiness and you don't inspect the vehicle? How do you want to explain to the whole world? Hold me, I will tell the whole world. I will call CNN, I call everybody. You, by the time you finish with me, the whole world will know what is going on. Brethren, we need the mercies of God. And Jesus took over the ceremony, stopped the people and touched the coffin and brought out the boy alive, and he rose up and began to talk and began to walk. He gave it to the mother, and the woman who was crying started to rejoice. Today, as you are hearing this voice, your sorrow shall be turned to joy. Weep no more. Seek the mercy of God. Seek him seriously and you will find him. Praise the Lord. Brethren, let us look at Psalm 103 verse 17.
Psalm 103, line 17.
Yes.
But the mercies of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting.
Okay.
On those who fear him, and his righteousness to children's children.
Brethren, if you need the mercy of God, you just fear him and call on him. His mercy endureth forever. We are dead. I'm one of them that have eaten from the mercy of God. Therefore, we need the mercy of God. If you look at Genesis 29:31, don't go there, and 30 verse 22 to 23, you will find the case of Lee and Rachel. You find their case there. They were both married to one husband. Am I correct? Okay. But Lee was hated because he's not the supposed something. There was envy and jealousy, rivalry among two sisters. And the womb was shut. No child. But it was for a time. The mercy of God remembered Lee. And God remembered Lee. And do what? Opened the womb. And the other one, Rachel, continued in her barrenness. And after some times, the same thing happened to this lady. And God remembered her. Can you imagine that? And God remembered Rachel. And God hearkened to her and opened her womb. And she conceived and bare a son and said, God has taken away my reproach. What happened to her? She received the mercy of God. The other one, and when the Lord saw that Lee was hated, he opened a womb. But Rachel was barren. He opened the womb. When God saw, if only you can be behaving as a Christian, when God will see how they mock you, how they despise you, how they oppress you, he will give you what will make your enemy to go and commit suicide. He will blow it upon you. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You can see my situation. They don't want to see me. They hate me. They envy. They jealousy. Ibaja eniyan ko da ise Olorun duro. The wrath of man, the wickedness of man, does not stop God from blessing Odigie. What about you? The anger of your family, does it stop God? Can a man climb up to meet God and say, don't bless Odigie? Who told you that? The mercy of God overtake everything that your enemy is doing. The mercy. You need it. You just have to cry for it. Because he said, I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy. And I will have compassion on whom I will have compassion. And the mercy of God is available. And the man called Jesus Christ is available. He's still going about doing good. But no more physically. Spiritual. And if God had not had mercy upon us, we would all become dead bodies in a nation that does not fear God. Brethren, we need to rise up and call upon the name of the living God today. And I want you to shout, and nobody is going to ring the bell between you and God. If you cannot stand up and you want to kneel down, and you are sober there, whatever you are doing now, stop it and call upon the Lord to have mercy and compassion on you. Today, our God, who is merciful, who is gracious, who is long-suffering, who is compassionate, is around. Stand on your feet. We want to call upon God. I want you to raise up your right hand and let heaven confirm blessing upon that hand. Say, oh God, I am here for you. Have mercy on me. Have mercy on me.
Have mercy on me.
Have mercy on me.
Let me eat.
Let me eat.
Of your table.
Of your table.
Of mercy.
Of mercy.
Of compassion.
Of compassion.
And let your grace fill me.
And let your grace fill me.
Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and call upon the God of Israel. Have mercy on me, O God. Have mercy on me. Have compassion on me. Let me eat of your mercy, your grace, your favor.
Have compassion.
Have mercy, Lord.
Have mercy.
Have mercy.
Have mercy on me, O God.